Do you know what Thomas' message said? It said, "Anne, I got the job!" And trust me, that was not part of the initial plan. What about you? What is your plan? And if you have one, do you ever wonder if it's the right one? If you're on the right path for it? If you've made the right choices? And if you'll be able to make the right choices your whole life through? Who ever wonders that? No one, right? We all know where we're going. It's the beginning of your life. Maybe for some of you, you're already a little more advanced in your careers. And yet, for everyone, this question brings up two reactions. The first one is excitement. I have a plan. It's so cool. I'm so excited. It's here. I can see it. It's a straight line. It's right here. It's calling me. It's shining at night. I'll make it. And then there's the other reaction, right? There is a kind of a plan. It's kind of over here. It's blurry. It's scary. I'm not sure I can make it. I'm not sure I'll stay on the path. I'm not sure it's for me. And I think all of us experience this. And what's interesting with it is that not only we feel like those questions can either make us move forward or paralyze us, but the people around us do a great deal for it as well, right? Those people who love us and care for us and think that the best thing for us would be to go from point A to point B, to use a very nice, simple straight line. This is me. About 25 years ago, we'll talk about it later. I was very athletic, but most importantly, I knew I wanted to be a psychologist. So it was going to be simple, right? The plan was made, the path was easy. My parents thought I'd go to university, study psychology, or languages, anything, right? So that I'd be doing something. But I was 18, and it wasn't that clear. I didn't know what I wanted to do. I didn't know how I would get there. I just knew I wanted to be a psychologist. So I decided I'd just take one little year off and take time to think. Very unwise, very unsafe, said most people around me. But I did it. Off I went to America, the country where the sky is the limit. I was an au pair for a year, and I loved it. And these kind of experiences are great because you learn so many things. You discover new cultures. You discover new people. And first of all, yourself. You discover the new person you are. You didn't know you were. It's the first time I had chances to discover the beauty of getting lost. And not just because it took me a very long time to be able to get back to the family house when I first arrived there, but also because I was off the path and I could just be myself and be free. The path was home, waiting for me. I had plenty of time to get back to it. I lived this incredible year, enjoying being a childcare provider and developing professional skills as I spent quite a lot of time helping the parents who were getting divorced. Developed great listening skills, patience, understanding. That was an interesting experience. But the year came to an end, and it was time to get back on my path. Life in America was not really imaginable. Home was waiting for me. Off I went. I arrived back home and felt really lonely, lost still. And it was really hard to fit in again. But I was lucky. My parents had signed me up to attend law university so that at least I would be doing something, right? And I was even luckier in that I passed the first year without any difficulties. and realized by the month of October that if I stayed any longer the second year, I would probably hang myself. Back to loneliness, back to quite, I could say, isolation, this feeling of not fitting in, and a path that was really, really blurry. But I was lucky. I was offered by my host family to come back to America, to live with them again, to help them with the children, what they would help me go to school. Great opportunity, right? I seized it. It's okay. The path could wait. I would get back to France. I would find my way around. It would be okay. I seized it and loved it. Nanny by day, international students by night, I discovered a new world again. I was living the American dream of the French girl in Denver. And I met mentors there, and those mentors were my teachers. And they showed us that we could trust them, that they would be here for us, that they were present, that they would challenge us, but that they trusted us. I was able to study communication, psychology, and social sciences, discovered new worlds, new horizons, loved every single step of it. This is me, 1997, first inter-college public speaking contest. I got third place. I was very proud of myself. I moved to Dallas after that, where I proudly graduated in communication, psychology, and social sciences. The world was mine. I had it all. Life, love, diplomas. Maybe there was a path for me in America. Something was missing, though. Start spreading the news. I'm coming today. I'm gonna be a part of it. New York, New York. Had to make it into the real big world, right? So I went to New York. In New York, I had another incredible experience. I was working 7 days a week and loved every single day of it. I was working as a sales representative for a French cosmetic company to pay the bills. And I was also working as a communication assistant for the High Commissioner for Refugees at the United Nations to follow my heart. I think the path was getting quite clear. The red carpet was opening up in front of me. I could see it, I could touch it, I could feel it. Incredible years. So my path was not in France after all, it was in America. I had it all. And then, two towers collapsed in the center of Manhattan, and life changed for a lot of people. For me, it meant that it was impossible to get a new visa to stay in America. But I was positive. I'd received a document that said that I'd been selected to get the green card through the lottery. So I went home very, very trusting that I would be back in no time. Went back home, felt good. I wasn't gonna stay very long. My path was in America. My life was in America. And then my boyfriend, who was waiting for me in America, met someone else. And I never received any document from the immigration services. It took a little while for me to be able to pick up a pen again and draw a new line and a new plan. The line had disappeared, but someone said, when the plan doesn't work, change the plan. Never change the goal. I wanted to be a psychologist. I even had experience now in social work with refugees. I was going to make it anywhere. If you want to be a psychologist, you need to start over. But I have a 4-year diploma in communication and psychology. Yes, but in France, it is not recognized. The line didn't disappear there. is the whole ground that vanished. Do you know the feeling? You've made so much efforts. You've put all you had into one plan, one goal. You've worked for it. You've seen it. It was so near. And it disappears. C'est la vie. I was lucky, though. Looking for a school where I could get a degree or maybe find value from my past experiences, I discovered the TEDxCIFE. And my past experiences were valued there. I was back on track. 1 year as an international student by day, English teacher by night. I had an incredible experience once again. I won't say too much more about that because some of you don't know yet what it's going to be like. We'll talk about it at the end of the year. And it was an incredible experience. I loved every day of it, every city of it, every teacher of it, every one of my colleagues in my promotion. But at the end of the year, I realized I could not afford to go to Brussels or one of the other cities to work for one of the institutions and get that work experience you're supposed to get through unpaid internships. So I decided to just start teaching, and I became a language teacher. Really enjoyed it. I helped people get out of their comfort zone, develop themselves, dare to try new things. But something was missing. However, one day, one of my students said, "Thanks to you, I'm changing. My life is changing. I'm daring to do things I would never have done before. Thank you." And I realized I was back on the path. This was my path, after all, and it was a good one. 8 years ago, I decided to create my own company, and I became a coach in communication and business. And I'm sure you imagine it was an easy choice to make, right? You weigh the opportunities against the threats. You rationally think, it's okay, I can make it. There is a need. I'll just jump in. Well, it's not exactly how it happened. But I decided to go for the jump. I closed my eyes real tight, mustered all the courage I could find, and jumped in. Life of an entrepreneur is a mix of joys and tears, happiness and doubts, successes and failures. But I went for it, and I have absolutely no regret today. Just like Thomas, who had worked his whole life to be a hospital director and decided one day to take a huge turn and apply for a position that he should never have gotten. Counselor at the highest level for the French government. But he did it. So, if you are thinking that you're not sure about your plan, if you're wondering if you're on the right track, if you're afraid of making mistakes, I want you to stop thinking immediately. Because, as Nicolas Bouvier said on the road, once one gets lost, this is when the real journey begins. Because plans can yield to surprises. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. Don't be afraid to take turns. Don't be afraid of sharp cuts. Let's turn them into shortcuts. Even though reality can be like that sometimes, there are things we can do to make those transitions more empowering. And the first thing I would like to do is for you to take out your phones, please. Or raise up your phones if they're already in your hands, and go to Facebook.
Yeah.
once on Facebook, I would like you to type the force of transitions and request to become a member of this group that I've created for all of us. Because the problem is not transitions. Transitions are the norms. Transitions are what we're going to experience every other day. The problem is the isolation we put ourselves in when going through transitions. And I think in the future, there's a way we can change that. And the solution is through connection. Let's stay connected. And let's make sure we help each other get empowered through every single one of their transitions. Because today, I shared with you some of my transitions. And now, I would like to hear your transitions. Thank you.